Have you recently tried, given a best shot at something, but horribly failed? If you have, let me congratulate you. Yes, because failure, after you have tried something, is an indication that you are pushing yourself out of your comfort zone. So what matters is not whether you have succeeded or you have failed. What matters the most is that you have pushed yourself out of your comfort zone. You have done something which is way beyond your current capacity. You have attempted doing something that you would have otherwise never thought of. You're trying something new. You know, as the great saying goes, the ships which never leave the shore are the ones which are the safest. But again, ships are never built for that. And that's exactly true with we human beings, right? But if you look at it, not many of us are ready to step out of our comfort zone. Why? And one of the biggest reasons for that why is fear. Fear of failure, fear of not making it, fear of being humiliated, fear of success sometimes. So all these fears, when they accumulate in our mind, it just gives us one signal, one message, and that is, don't go ahead. Don't try something new. Why does our mind do that to us? And the answer is actually not a secret at all. The answer is, the mind does all that to us to protect us, because that's the only function, rather the biggest function of our mind, to protect ourselves. So when you still go ahead, you know, other than what your mind tells you, other than what your fears try to pull you back, if you're still going out on that path of progress and trying something way out of your comfort zone, that itself makes you a success. So whether or not you have succeeded at what you were trying, or whether you have failed, what matters the most is you have tried. You have got out of your comfort zone. And maybe this was your first trial, your second trial, your fourth trial, your 100th trial. But the fact is, as long as you don't give up, you are never a failure. So that's really the message that I have. And why am I giving this message? So here is my little secret. This week, I dreamt something huge. So Tony Robbins and Dean Graziosi were looking for their next speakers. And out of probably 20,000 people or 18,000 people, there were around 500 and 600 people who applied for it. And I was one among them, although I had no hopes of making it to the round one. But still, getting out of my comfort zone and, you know, telling myself, it's okay, let me just go ahead and apply, let me see what happens. That itself gave me a huge boost. Did I make it to round two? No, not this time. But am I going to give it up? No, not at all. I'm not going to stop trying until I succeed. As my seven-year-old son says, try until you succeed. So failures, embrace them. Failures, look at them with a big smile. Every time you encounter a failure, give yourself a pat on your back for trying it on the first place. But one thing that you should never do is giving up. Dare you give up on your dreams. Never, ever give up on your dreams. And most importantly, embrace failures. Pat yourself on the back. I know I'm repeating it, but that's because it's very, very important. One thing that you should love doing every time is stepping out of your comfort zone, doing something new, even if it scares you. And will you succeed? Maybe not for the first time, but will you eventually succeed? I guarantee the answer is yes. This is Rupa, and thank you for being with me. I wish you all the best for all your successes, of current successes and future successes. Never give up, never stop dreaming. Bye-bye.